2 on streaming objects from MinIO using our Python client API. And in this video, we are using Python 3.9, and we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io. That's our online sandbox where anybody can work with our MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio Code. Just to get a little more detail on what you can expect to be able to do at the end of this video, we're going to be getting into the getObject method and some of the variables you can use to get a stream. That stream comes to you in the form of an HTTP response. And what we're going to be doing with that response is reading it, and then we're going to make sure that we close and release that connection. Let's take a look at the code. So here in our code, I've imported MinIO. I've also imported this MinIO demo functions. It's a collection of functions that allows me to do some scaffolding so that I can just show you the code that I'm interested in. I'm also going to have two strings that I'm going to work with. A bucket name, which is our Python demo bucket, and our object name, which is hello world text. That's just a text file, and we're going to stream that down in an HTTP response. So the code that we're going to work with here is client.getObject. It takes at a very minimum a bucket and an object that you want to stream down. We'll see in just a minute, it also can take an offset and a length. It can take headers, extra query parameters. If you're looking for a particular version or you're looking to use server-side encryption, you can also work with all of that as well. But just at a basic level, we're going to get this object from this bucket. It gets handed to us in a response. Now, the response is not part of the MinIO libraries. It's actually part of the URL lib libraries. And so we need to read from that response to actually have something to print. So that response.read, it's going to give me basically a byte stream. It's not a file stream. It's going to give me a byte stream, and it's going to print that out for me. I have to put this into a try because anything could go wrong. We could have an issue with the connection or something along those lines, or maybe our HTTP response gets interrupted. So I also want to have this finally where I close and release the connection. Very important to close and release the connection. Okay, let's save and run this. Python 3. Demo py. And what we get out is our hello world. This is handed to me in the form of a byte stream. You can see there right at the beginning, the B, let all these things just sort of happen. This is a stream of bytes. It's text, so I can actually read it. It's not an image or anything like that. And this is all just a Bob Ross lorem ipsum. It's just some random quotes. It comes out quite nicely. It gives us something to look at. So very simply, that is how we are going to do a get object. That's how we read it, and that's how we can close it, release the connection. If I don't want to print it, I don't have to. I can do whatever else I need to. Let me show you the offset and the length. We'll give it an offset of 1270 and a length of 32. And what happens when we do that? Well, we're going to get just one of the quotes out of this. It's a great one. Don't be bashful, drop me a line. And that's how I want to end this particular how-to. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to drop me a line, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.